welcome back, guys. Welcome back, guys. So let's continue. Last time we just got the sword, Zelda got cursed, met Valky, blah blah blah. And now we have to fix the core sword to save Zelda. In order to do that, we have to go to the Minishrooms. Now I don't remember this game really well, so alright, so we can't go to the Hyrule Town, unfortunately, so we just have to go to it. Like I said, I don't remember this game really well, because I only played through it twice, but I really loved it, so that's why I'm playing it. So I guess we have to go through here. Okay, this is long, long run. Okay, this is a I guess there's supposed to be a combination of mall and bandits. Alright, we have to go down. We can go here, but I think it's locked. Can't even open it. I guess not. There's nothing really here, so let's continue down. Sorry, but like I said, I don't remember this game. I really hope I remember this world, because there's a side quest that involves this and there are a lot of them. And I really hope I remember this one, because it's really hard. So, let's go down. These are octo rods. Yeah, you can't swim when you get damage, but there's a hard piece over there. Remember, you can get that with the other. I hope I get that. As you can see here, this one is blocking the path. You have to do a special event or some kind of. You don't need a specific item to do so. I'll explain later what you have to do. Alright, I guess I can't. How am I supposed to get that hard piece? Remember, I could get it really early. Maybe not. Alright, let's go down there. Okay, there's this. Still stuck. But we can't do anything here. Help! Help me! Ouch! Want someone to stop them? Oh, help! Somebody! Can't anybody hear me? Well, somehow we can, but before we go there, let's get this heart. You got a heart piece of heart. Collect four to make it. Except the Twilight Princess, you need to go to the Let's go save that heart. So, anyways, is anyone excited for the Pokemon Sun and Moon? Recently, they released a trailer about Alolan Rattata, which looks really weird. Hey kid, you there! Ow! Hey, don't just stand there, do something! Ow! What's wrong with you? Do you like watching me take this abuse? Help me! Maybe I do. Anyways, they just introduced a lone Rattata with a distortion of blood. It's a new type, but kind of fighting a bit. Phew, well done, that was close. Not that I couldn't handle it myself. No, you couldn't. Why did you call for my help? But that's beside the point. What in the world is a lone child doing so deep in the woods? Oh, I see. Cory, you say? And Vati? Vati's cursed someone? Vati's cursed someone? Vati has cursed someone. What? The second blade? Is that so? I see. You know, you and I have quite a lot in common. You see, I too am on a quest to break the curse of Vati's. You say that reforging the sacred blade can break this curse, eh? Well, then you have found yourself a companion, my friend. My name is Ezlo. It's a pleasure to meet your acquaintance. Oh, wait, wait, I say. You walk so quickly, too quickly, in fact. Can't you just go any slower? Surely you've noticed that I have no legs. Boy, take a good look at me. Do you really think I can walk that fast? Well, just hop. Ah. Oh. If it isn't one thing, it's another. You are a troublesome boy. Well, that's easy. That's convenient. There, now we can pass to the mic. It's quite comfortable up here. More comfortable than it looks, surely. And much easier to on me. Hey, quit your squirming. Can't you sit still, see there? Yes, yes, that's it. Much better. Now, I suppose a boy like you still has much to learn about the world. If you ever need my insight, press select. I'll be happy to help. Ah, such a hopeless child. Jeez, thanks, Ezlo. Ezlo actually is a pretty good fan of my favorites. So anyways, like I said, they choose a normal Rattata and it's normal Dark, which is okay. I mean, it's a good type, but it's more than like a Dark type. I think it's pretty cool as well. They also introduced Snorlax for Z, but it squashes you. It's called Pancake Popularizer, I guess. Hold on for a moment, my boy. We've stumbled across something important. The world of the Minish is very small. You're far too big to meet some of them there. Eh? Who are the Minish? Ah, yes, silly me. Allow me to explain. You humans call them Pikori, but they refer to themselves as the Minish. Strange how in the world of humans, only this force has kept that name. Anyhow, in the forest, they built a tiny village where the Minish now live. But if we were to enter the village, we'll have to get to a touch smaller first. Look at that. At first glance, it appears to be a mere stump, yes? No, that was a portal used by people long ago to adjust their size. Now with my help, you can use it to shrink down to your size. Just stand on the stump and press R to shrink. Then return to normal and stand next to the stump and press R. Let me up there. Press R and press shrink. Now, this is my favorite thing about the game. During the turns, there are a lot of things to explore in this finish. A lot of hard pieces. Yeah, hard pieces, but like the secrets to find. Eyes of a Minish. Now aren't you glad you saved me? No need to thank me though. Portals that reduce your size are all around in different shapes and sizes. If you want to return to normal, just stand next to the press star. But there's one thing you must know. Big Minish size is full of dangers. Clear portals at your normal size are bottomless swamps to the Minish. And as your companion, if anything bad happens to you, it happens to me too. But proceed with caution, my lad. If not for you, save then for my own. So yeah, I'm pretty excited for Sun and Moon. My favorite Pokemon so far has been Mewtwo and then Crabrawl. They both look pretty awesome. And I prefer the Moon Legendary over the Sun Moon. It looks so mysterious and I love both types. So yeah, I'm gonna buy Moon over Sun. How about you guys? So let's proceed. It appears we have found the rest of the Pikori! 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 I gather it's been quite some time since they last saw a human. What's that? You didn't understand what they were saying? Just now? Ah yes, that was the language of the Minish. It's a little different from the dialect I am most familiar with. I'm afraid I didn't catch most of what they said myself. Perhaps there is someone here who understands your language. We should look around. There's also Pipmark color splash. I have no idea who's excited for the game, honestly. I mean, it looks okay, yeah. Kind of fun, maybe. But I really miss old games like Mario 64 and 2002. Oh yeah, here there's another heart piece. So it's wait, that's not true. So let's go here. This looks important. I mean, it's a huge building, so it must be important. I've never seen an outfit like that before. Are you a human? Oh my, it's been quite some time since any humans came here. My name is Festari. I watched the Abbey as well as the Shrine of the Moon. Seem to be having some trouble with our language, don't you? You could use a Jabberwock, it will allow you to understand our language. You should be able to find one in the barrel of my house just to stop. Oh, thanks. So yeah, let's go find the Jabberwock so we can understand the language. So yeah, color splash, it looks kind of fun, but it's still a little boring. Oh, moving. The Revenant, the story told you talking about. Well, it would be better use it if you plan to make any progress at all. trying to make a playthrough of the Cup of Colors first. Yes, okay. So you beat the Jabberwock and now you can understand your house. The other said that humans can no longer see us as they once could. It's amazing that you can't see us. Well, on the same side, maybe that's why. So let's go back to the first part. So you've eaten the Jabberwock, and now you can understand us. Sorry, but I know a little about swords. I'm sure the elder can help you. So let's go talk to the elder. The elder should be back here, yeah. This is important to your house, this is our important as well first. How is what exactly? Alright, so this is elder, so let's talk to him. Oh, you speak our language? It's been quite a while since we've heard an outsider speak our language or tongue. We have little to offer you in these woods, but please enjoy your stay. Thank you for your offer, but we have no time to relax. My name is Eslok. This child is Lumen. We need to break a curse that has been cast on the Princess of Fire. To do so, we'll need to report the broken for it. Ah, yes, and you've come here now hoping to have the blade before it. Well, if that's what you're after, we'll need four mystic elements. These elements are the crystalline forms of the energies of this world. Only by fusing a blade with these energies can the new blade be formed. Here, give me your map. I can mark where these elements come from. Okay, so there are four elements. One of them are rocks. The earth element can be found in the shrine to the north of Vestari's Abbey. Speak with Vestari, he will show you the path to the shrines. Go with caution and leave the creatures of blade for you. Return to me once you have found the earth. So once we have found once we've gotten the earth element, we have to return. Very well, this way. Thank you, Vestari. Wild beasts have settled in recently. Be careful, it's quite dangerous. We're the hero. Oh yeah, I want to go. So remember, this is the world that took the hard place. So, the dungeon is right. This is the first dungeon of the game. Now, I have to say, all of the dungeons in this game are pretty good. Are amazing, actually. So this would be the Duke Shrine the Minish Elder spoke of. He said something about there being some monster inside, didn't he? Hey, no reason to be afraid or anything. I'll be waiting right here. No, wait, what am I saying? I'm not letting you leave me alone out here. So yeah, we can't do anything about this world right now, so let's go on. Like I said, I really like the dungeons in this game, so I can't wait to explore more. This is one of the few Zelda games with the dungeon that I actually hate. Or like none of the dungeons I actually hate in this game. The only game that have dungeons that I don't explore in this game. Like I said, Majora's Mask and Skyward Sword. I love all the dungeons in these three games. So when you have to light the torches to get some Zelda key, I guess. It's a puzzle, but a great way to do some sword. You got a small key. I've played a lot of Zelda games before, but I've played this already. Anyways, we've got this slightly fun to see. There's and now we've got the top bridge. Now let's pull this mushroom. So we can cut it to the other side. This is really amazing. So let's go deep. Okay, these enemies can't beat right now. Oh, look at the size of that barrel. Oh, right. How silly of me. It's not big, we're just small. Yeah. Now we have to do the same to on the other side. So let's go inside. Push this here. And then like now the we can move the barrel more. It can be rolled. So I'm gonna be starting school or university in September 17. We had a very long vacation, about 4 months. So we are come here and we are about to need another game. So let's roll the cards. Xenon excited for Colored Splash. I rarely hear people actually getting excited for it, which is kind of sad. And just shows how much people installed it. I'm not really saying it's going to be a bad game, but it certainly won't be as good as the first two from looking at it. And recently, Nintendo has been releasing these videos about the rescue from Squad 5, and it looks weird. It makes the game more enjoyable than it previously looked. There's something good. One of the things that I really hate about the game is the battle style or how you fight enemies. I mean, they showed a video about fighting one of the Koopalings, which are supposed to be the bosses, which is kind of disappointing. And they looked pretty boring to fight or pretty easy to beat. If you have the right item, you can run, you lose. Which is just one of the major problems with Super Circuit. A lot of people hated it. Okay, here we are supposed to go. So yeah, like I was saying, the Koopalings they look like they are the bosses of the game. And from the looks of it, the final boss is going to be Bowser, since he is and let's be honest here, I've never seen a game where the Koopalings are the main bosses. Final boss. I don't think so. Plus it's a plot twist. Maybe Dry Bowser will be the final boss. Maybe. Anyways, we got to have another key and we have to use it up here. So guys, before you head there, you have to go. Let's go down here first. Just a dark day. fighting the mid boss. I hate these enemies, we can't even beat them right now, that's a problem. We open this door. Okay. Yeah, I think this door just leads you back to the barrel. Yeah. So if you. It's just a shortcut, I guess. I think I can beat these enemies. It's actually blocked. There's a web, so we have to use the other door. And we need a small key for it. But we have a small key, so let's open it and go. And this is the mini box. But mad blue, I guess. We have to let it close and then it's the through the game a lot, and just I really hated that game a lot. I've beaten it once, and I tried playing through it again, but it's just so there's so many things wrong with that game, especially the combat system. So anyways, I got a new item, the gas rock. You can search this anyways, let's go here and get a third heart piece. Before we end this episode, let's get a new heart piece and continue our heart container. Get the heart container. Yeah, let's continue. Anyways, as you can see, there's a heart piece over there, but how are we supposed to get it? Oh yeah, and this is how you get it. You just suck the heart in the head. So, there's supposed to be a switch around. Oh yeah, there is. Go back to the first beginning. So let's finish. Heart container. Yay, we're live and driving. So anyway guys, I really hope you enjoyed this episode, and I'm gonna continue soon. I'm gonna upload the third episode soon. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. Please like and subscribe. Bye.